So, in this video, we'll be studying about SDS PAGE, which is sodium dodecyl sulfate polyacrylamide gel electrophoresis. SDS PAGE is mainly carried out for the separation of proteins. For carrying out SDS PAGE, the samples, that is the protein samples, are prepared using tris buffer, which maintains the pH, glycerol, which gives the sample enough density so that it can settle inside the well, bromophenol blue, which is used as a tracking dye, 2-mercaptoethanol, and SDS. A protein molecule exists in a folded secondary or tertiary structure in its native form. In these structures, disulphide bonds are formed between the sulfur residues on two cysteine molecules. Beta-mercaptoethanol or 2-mercaptoethanol basically reduces these disulphide bonds, leading to a denatured unfolded form of the protein. This denaturation is triggered by heat. SDS binds to the unfolded protein and solubilizes it. SDS also provides an overall negative charge to the entire protein. Approximately 1 SDS molecules bind to 2 amino acids. Proteins differ from each other on the basis of size as well as charge. But since the proteins are denatured with an overall negative charge due to SDS, the movement on the gel will not be based upon the charge of the protein, but it will be based only on the size of the protein. The concentration of the gel depends upon the amount of acrylamide added in the buffer. As you can see, if more acrylamide molecules are present, there is less space between the molecules. And when less acrylamide molecules are present, there is enough space between the molecules. Thus, the pore size of the gel depends upon the concentration of acrylamide that is being used to prepare the gel. Acrylamide gel is weighed properly and it is prepared in the buffer. TEMED and APS is added when you are ready to pour the gel components into the gel cassette, because after addition of TEMED and APS, the polymerization will start occurring. First, the resolving gel is loaded into the gel cassette, followed by the stacking gel. After the resolving gel is loaded into the gel cassette, it is allowed to solidify. Saturated butanol or isopropanol is added to avoid oxygen and to facilitate proper polymerization of the gel matrix. After the resolving gel is ready, the stacking gel is loaded and the comb is added for the formation of the wells. After complete polymerization, the gel cassette is placed into the running buffer and then the samples can be loaded onto the wells. A polyacrylamide gel is made up of acrylamide and bis-acrylamide monomers. These monomers are polymerized to form the gel matrix. The polymerization is done using TEMED and APS. TEMED decomposes ammonium persulfate to give free radicals. Free radical species are highly reactive. They have an unpaired electrons and thus they form single bond with another monomers. This creates an equally reactive radical which will react with another monomer and form long chains. The long chains that are formed must be cross-linked so as to form the gel matrix. This cross-linking between the long chain is carried out by bisacrylamide. The stacking gel has low acrylamide concentration, that is, it has a high pore size that allows the proteins to migrate freely and get stacked between the interface of the stacking gel and the running gel. Hence, it is named as the stacking gel. The purpose of this is to make sure that all the proteins start to migrate from the same level, since they are expected to separate on the basis of their mass. The resolving gel contains a higher concentration of acrylamide. That means it is having a comparatively less pore size, which is capable of retarding the movement of the proteins. Thus, it is the resolving gel where actually the separation of your protein molecules will take place. Another difference between the stacking gel and the resolving gel lies in the pH. The stacking gel is buffered with tris and the pH is adjusted to 6.8. Whereas for running or resolving gel, the pH is adjusted to around 8.8. The running buffer is tris glycine, which is adjusted to pH 8.3. We'll understand what is the importance of this pH difference in SDS PAGE. Glycine can exist in three different charge stages, that is positive, neutral or negative, depending upon the pH. At low pH, glycine has an overall positive charge, whereas at high pH, it is having an overall negative charge. At neutral pH, it exists in the Zwitter ion form, wherein it will have neutral charge on it. When the power is turned on, the glycine molecules at pH 8.3, which are in the negative charge, start moving towards the positive electrode and they are forced to enter into the stacking gel. Now, once they enter the stacking gel, the pH changes to 6.8. 6.8 is around a neutral pH, wherein glycine will switch to the Zwitter ion form and it will acquire a neutral charge. Since now it is neutral, it will move very slowly in the electric field. The gel is buffered with tris-HCl. In tris-HCl, the chloride ions move very quickly towards the cathode in the electric field, and they migrate much ahead of the glycine molecules. The separation of chlorine ions from the tris counter ions create a narrow zone with a steep voltage gradient that pulls glycine molecules along with it, behind it. Thus, two layers of ions are formed, wherein you have highly mobile chloride ions followed by the slower glycine molecules. All of the proteins in the gel sample have an electrophoretic mobility, that is intermediate between the two extremes of glycine and chloride. So, when the two layers sweep through the sample wells, the proteins are concentrated in a narrow zone between the glycine and the chlorine ions. The proteins can never outrun the chloride ions. If they did, they will find themselves in a region of high conductance and very low field strength, and so they will immediately slow down. Thus, the proteins are like a sandwich patty between chloride ions and glycine molecules. The proteins move in this sandwich manner till it hits the running gel. In the running gel, the pH is 8.8, and at this pH, the glycine molecules are mostly negatively charged and they will start migrating faster than the proteins towards the positive electrode. So, the glycine molecules have moved away and the proteins are dumped in a very narrow band at the interface between the stacking gel and the running gel. Since the running gel has increased acrylamide concentration, it slows the movement of the proteins. And now the protein can start separating based upon the size of the proteins, and the separation of the protein begins. This slide is basically to show you how exactly the samples are loaded onto the wells using a micropipette, and after the loading is done, an electric field is applied, after which the samples will start running and separating onto the gel matrix. After the gel is done, it can be removed and stained using coomassie brilliant blue or silver nitrate to visualize the protein. Western blot can also be carried out with the gel. There are various applications of SDS PAGE, that is analyzing the protein mixtures, monitoring about the protein purification, like if a protein is desired in the pure form, then we expect that only one band of that particular protein at the desired size will be obtained, and other proteins which are there in the sample will get eliminated. It is also used to determine the relative molecular mass of proteins, as separation is basically based on the size of the molecules.
If this video was helpful to you, then please like this video, share it with your friends, subscribe to my channel, and don't forget to leave us your valuable comments. Thank you.